duty or your assignment that day while you were at the apartment?
After getting with the other CSIs, I was tasked with collecting the evidence.
So everything that's marked?
Yes, ma'am. And that was a joint evidentiary search, all of us included. So.
What was the state of the apartment as you guys walked through it and searched?
Well, there was a lot of personal effects left, a lot of trash. Obviously, somebody had vacated the premises. Just possible evidentiary items, DNA, cleansers and cleaners and liner gloves and things as such.
Talk the jury as we're watching, what are objects are you guys zooming in on? So what would this number 8 be?
Well, number 8 would be a used Band-Aid.
And this would be number 9, correct?
That's correct. Clothing and child's panties.
And then here at number 10.
Liners, glove liners.
Have we already seen several pairs of gloves on this video so far?
Yes, throughout the apartment there was... The sock and the Band-Aid.
What's being zoomed in on right now?
Thumbtacks. Looks like a 7.62 long gun. Yes, ma'am. It looks like a 7.62 long gun ammo.
And then here at number 13.
Some type of case, some type of, I'm not too sure what you call it.
And
receipt. Another sock. Yeah, it was some type of stain that was checked for apparent blood.
Number 17.
More hair strands.
What is that?
27 was the sandals. Looked like it was a soiled puppy pad. The sock. Matted hair.
Number 20.
Also matted hair. Some type of substance.
Number 23.
I believe it was a upper garment.
Like a top.
Like a top, yes. Thumbtack.
And what's here at number 25, if you know?
Yes, it looked like the package for a bandage. Or a partial.
Number 26. Pato, how many clumps of hair were collected in the crime scene?
I would have to refer to my